students, welcome back to the second part of the class which is discussing about physical quantities and measurement. Let us recall what we have learned in previous class. In last class, we have learned about a physical quantity named area. We have learned about its definition, different units of area and its relation with SI unit. It's simple and formula for measuring the area of regular solids. In today's class, let us learn the method for measuring area of an irregular object. To estimate the area of an irregular object, graph paper is used. Irregular object means the objects which does not have regular shape. For example, we cannot name the proper shape of a stone or leaf. But if it is a ball, we can name its shape as sphere. That means here stone and leaf are irregular objects and ball is a regular object. I'm repeating once again, to estimate the area of an irregular object, graph paper is used. Now, what is a graph paper? Yeah, you can see that it is a sheet of paper on which horizontal and vertical lines are ruled at a regular interval of 1 millimeter. When you are focusing to the graph paper, you can see many horizontal lines and vertical lines. The lines in this direction represents horizontal lines and the lines in this direction represents vertical lines. Then we can see many lines with small gaps in between. I am focusing one set of such lines with blue ink. The gap between these two lines represents 1 millimeter. Then we can observe many lines with dark green lines running in horizontal and vertical direction. When we are measuring the space between two such lines, we will come to see the gap between them is 1 centimeter. Likewise, I am representing the gap between two such lines in horizontal direction also. That is 1 centimeter. Now we can see a square formed with each side 1 centimeter. So we can say that the area of each such squares in the graph paper is 1 centimeter square. I am repeating once again. Area of each squares in the graph paper with the side 1 centimeter is 1 centimeter square. It is very easy procedure for finding area of an irregular object using graph paper. Now let us see the procedure for finding area of a leaf which is an irregular object using graph paper. For that, the first step that we have to do is that take a graph paper and place the leaf upon it. Step 2. Draw an outline of the leaf on graph paper. I'm drawing the outline. And then remove the leaf from the graph paper. So we will get an outline like this. Step 3. First count the number of complete squares within the outline. Then count the number of incomplete squares which are half and more than half. Then ignore the squares which are less than half. Now let us see how to do it. I have already marked some squares using tick mark and some squares using cross mark. The specialty of those squares which I marked with tick mark is they are complete squares, and the squares which I marked with cross mark is incomplete squares. So let us count how many complete squares I have marked. I have already marked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 complete squares I have marked using tick mark. We can see some more complete squares are left within the outline. Let us mark that also using tick mark. You can use circles, stars or dots for marking the complete squares and incomplete squares. It is according to your wish. Here I am using tick mark and cross mark. So how many complete squares we got here? Yeah, we got 19 complete squares. Then let us see the remaining one. After 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, then 37. So we got 37 complete squares within the outline. Then I have already marked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 boxes using cross mark. The specialty of those boxes are they are half or more than half squares within the outline. So we got already 6. Let us count the remaining ones. So after 6 we will cross mark 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, then 12. Okay. So we have tick marked the complete squares and we have cross marked the half or more than half squares. Then some more boxes are left within the outline and those boxes are less than half squares. So we are not doing anything with that. We are ignoring it. Now let us write the steps for finding the area of this irregular object. So the first step is number of complete squares, that is equal to 37. Number of half or more than half squares is equal to 12. Now we are going to find the area of a leaf. For that we are using a formula, that is number of complete squares plus number of half or more than half squares. It is very easy. We have to just add the total number of complete and half or more than half squares. And when we are adding it, we have to represent it with the unit centimeter square. Why we are using centimeter square? We have seen that one box of graph paper has an area of 1 centimeter square. That is why we are multiplying 1 centimeter square with number of complete squares and number of half or more than half squares. So by using this formula, we can find area of any irregular solids. So now let us substitute the values. We know that number of complete squares is 37 and number of half or more than half squares is equal to 12. So we will substitute that. So when we are adding this 37 and 12, we will get a value of 49. Then we have to write the unit, that is centimeter square. So we got the area of this leaf is equal to 49 centimeter square. This is the activity 1 which is discussed in page number 4 of the physics textbook. So, you have to read the textbook. Okay. Then you have to do this activity. For doing this activity, if you don't have graph paper, no need of worrying. Take the ruler, pencil and a plain paper. Draw horizontal and vertical lines such that the lines must possess a spacing of 1 centimeter each, and then you can try. That's all about area we have learned. We have learned that how to measure the area of an irregular object using graph paper. And in previous class, we have learned how to measure area of a regular object using formula. So here we are winding up with today's class. Thank you for listening to the class.